I think it's important for people in the medical oncology area to recognize that there are a variety of risk groups that make up the non-muscle invasive patients. The high-risk patients that are not responding to BCG are likely to be showing up in medical oncologists' offices as the use of some of the IO drugs are moved forward to earlier stage tumors. But it's important to understand the biology of these tumors, the natural history of these tumors, where progression will occur to muscle invasion or spread if there's too much of a delay with therapy. So I think urologists and medical oncologists are going to be working much more closely together with these patients. And they're both going to learn together about the biology of this disease, the natural history of this stage, as well as integrating the use of some of these new systemic therapies.